Science fiction. Is it destroying the planet? Can there be a wrong type of sci-fi? Learn how science fiction affects science fact and why we need more of the right kind of sci-fi. That's today's BFD. We're doomed! Well, maybe not. But modern sci-fi seems to think so. Lately, science fiction has ranged from the Hunger Games to the, well, we're fed pretty well, but we're still killing each other anyway, games. While the state of science fiction may not seem like that big of a deal, remember, a lot of the technology we use today was first imagined by sci-fi authors decades before they became reality. The inventor of the submarine said he got the idea from 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. The creator of rockets was inspired by War of the Worlds. And Star Trek, well, they gave us everything from cell phones to iPads to a possible chance of functional warp drive. Seriously, there's a link to the article below. Here, engage! Engage in learning! Today's sci-fi doesn't have the same eye on lofty goals and new horizons. What kind of world do today's stories envision? Resource wars, apocalyptic gas prices, oppressive government. Basically the same as today, but worse. All that's gonna inspire is a well-stocked doomsday bunker. Neal Stephenson, an author for famous works like Snow Crash, has seen enough. He's created a project dedicated to returning sci-fi to its more optimistic roots. Project Hieroglyph's first step is an anthology of stories from some of the best authors in the business. These non-apocalyptic stories are designed to feature the kind of optimism that challenges readers, as Stephenson would say, to get big things done. These stories won't feature hackers, holocausts, or hyperdrive, but lunar colonies, megastructures, and alternative energy concepts. These are tales that Stephenson hopes will give someone the idea that if I start working on it now, by the time I retire, it just might exist. This isn't the kind of science that creates apps. We have too many apps. Soon there'll be an app that creates apps, and then all the other app creators will be out of a job, and it'll be doomsday all over again, and you see the cycle. Even if the works of Project Hieroglyph don't lead to innovations directly from their pages, they may still spark the reader's interest in science. The Walking Dead is a great show, but it's not fostering a new crop of young scientific minds. Probably upping attendance at crossbow classes, though. Project Hieroglyph hopes to inspire a generation to tackle problems as big and revolutionary as putting a man in space was so many years ago. These are goals so lofty we haven't even dreamt them into existence yet. But, after all, that's what science fiction is for. Check out Project Hieroglyph's webpage for more information on the book and the next steps for the budding movement. And if you're a budding sci-fi writer yourself, maybe some new discoveries will put you on the path to inspiration. Go to nsf.gov/discoveries to see what new innovations are coming out of investments from the National Science Foundation. For VFD, I'm Leland Bowden, and be sure to subscribe.